What's going on? The Rules here, and welcome back to another episode of my show Addressing Issues. This is the last episode of season 2, so you know. Gonna take a break from it, gonna make other videos, and gonna go back to season 3 maybe, but we'll see how it's gonna go. So, let's address some shit. Raka Russa. I actually prefer longer videos, Emil, especially when you are doing a video on the topic. A lot of times I don't agree with you because I'm conservative libertarian and a Christian. Okay. Conservative libertarian. You know, last year, it was like summer of last year, when I went kayaking with my Christian buddies, by the way. I hung out. There was one guy. He was actually a libertarian. And I actually agree with guy on some things, like, for example, he didn't like health insurance and all of that. He was saying that it's cheaper to pay sometimes out of pocket rather than pay premiums. Me, myself, I don't have health insurance, so I pay the penalty, actually. But I don't give a damn, because it's cheaper for me to pay the penalty rather than to actually buy insurance. But generally, I don't agree with the penalty either. Because if it's a free country, why should I even have health insurance? Should be a choice. If I don't want to have it, it's my fucking problem. That's what I believe in. So I don't know if that's the reason why I don't agree with me about being libertarian. Maybe, maybe not, but you can tell me about it. Because see, I don't consider myself anything. Because I'm from Russia, I just have my agenda, I have my ideas. I don't put labels on myself at all, so. But when it comes to being a Christian, yes. Although I do respect Jesus Christ, I believe that he was a prophet and possibly a Jewish Messiah. He was definitely a prophet, I tell you that. But the reason I don't believe him is a God, because he didn't create the universe. I know it may be offensive to you. Why? Because you've been taught from your childhood, dear Raka Russa, that you've just been endorsed or whatever, like, into Christianity, you know, just believe in that stuff. And I don't. I didn't grow up with it. And you know, the thing is, it's like your childhood, okay, affects your life. Like, for example, my story. My mom was telling me, my mom was eating some pork and telling me not to eat it because I'm Jewish. I remember it till this day. Then my mom was telling me, you know, because I was a hardworking guy, he was calling me a black man, you know, an N-word. Because in Russia, N-word is not bad. So she was telling me, because in Russia, we think that black people were very hardworking, right? And we call them N-word, like nigger. And that's not offensive. Russian people, they say this word not because they are like racist. It's just because this is how we call black people. It's nothing really racist about it. It's nothing hateful about black people. But so my mom was comparing me to black people because I was hardworking. And in Russia, people think that, you know, hardworking people, they like blacks because they have, they know in Russia that black people used to be slaves on plantation. That's the extent of what Russian people know about blacks. That's about it. But my mom was comparing me to that. And look at me right now. I'm actually dating black African woman. Then I was asking my mom, if I'm not a Jew, what kind of ethnicity I look like. And she said, well, you may be passing for Georgian, Italian, Turkish. And see, close to my place, there is a guy who owns Turkish place, right? He's a owner of the cafeteria. He's Turkish. Then I used to live with one girl, she was Italian. So I see a lot of Turk and Italians. Then I remember my grandmom used to watch soap operas, Brazilian. I have friends in Venezuela. Then my mom was telling me that I could pass for Iraqi. Here we go. I actually have one Iraqi friend. So see on this example, and then I can take brother Nathaniel too, like that guy, let's take his example. He will grow up as a Jewish, but his friends were Christians, right? So he was basically hanging out with Christians and singing Joy to the World. And right now he became really, really hard Christian because he was growing up a little bit a Christian. His friends were Christian and he was influenced by Christianity. So see how it works? From the childhood, the ideas which you get in your childhood are affecting your entire life. Because when you're a kid, you're kind of like a sponge which gets information. And then you get an adult, your views get solidified. And this is how it works, okay? Your views get solidified and you get certain ideas based on your childhood. See how strong the connection is. So you, dear Aka Russo, the reason why I bring it up, you've probably been indoctrinated to Christianity. So, and I didn't. That's why we have difference in our backgrounds. And there is nothing I can do. Like me, all these random things from my childhood led me to meeting all these people and led me to actually being pro-black at the age of 28. And then before, I made the video Black People Are Awesome, saying that Tupac is awesome and fuck white people. I was drunk, but I did say that. I know nobody paid attention, nobody took me seriously. That's why people liked my video, because I was drunk. But now I'm sober, I say the same things, people thumb me down. But the point being is that, see, and besides, I used to listen to rap too, which is black music. So I was just into that. It's like psychological thing, see? That's why with you, Christianity, it's a psychological thing, the way you're raised. So I probably cannot change you, but like I said, because I'm different and I grew up differently. I have different mentality about it. So that's just a difference of the backgrounds. That's why we don't agree. So let's continue. But I do try to get your point as much as I possibly can. Good job, and I appreciate that. You're not being a hater, you're actually trying to understand me as an individual. That's why I respect you, Aka Russo. If you are making a video and it's only 3 or 4 minutes, you can't really lay out your arguments in a proper fashion. True. So by all means, make them as long as you feel you need to. It's your channel. So do as you want, Emil. Thanks, Aka Russo, good comment. Thumbs up. Now, let's get back to the assholes here, because I got only 2.5 minutes. Todd likes underage girls, spread the word. I have nothing to say. Forget about it, asshole. Lifeguard. In England, we used to call cigarettes fags, though it's not used much these days. Faggots is an unpleasant word for the gay man. That's in America, yeah, I guess I miss that fag or faggot, because in the United States, fag is a so shortened form of the word faggot. So I just misspoke, I guess, but it's the same thing. Though again, it's not used very often anymore. Okay, so, alright. Mr. Matt 40 ounce. Shut it down, learn baseball and come back strong, drink only malt liquor. First of all, I don't want to drink, I feel ashamed when I'm drinking on camera anymore. Second of all, I'm not shutting my channel down. If you don't like watching my videos, don't fucking watch them. Go ahead and unsubscribe, I don't need no fucking stupid ass haters here. If you don't like it, go fuck out of here. Don't tell me what to do. And if you're concerned about my reputation, that's the reason why. Well, I'm a grown man. I'm not your kid, so I'll figure it out and I'll talk about it later. Report Todd for being a sex offender. Why should I report Todd? Look, Todd has problems. Don't even fucking mess with Todd, man. He shouldn't go to jail. Let's be a little bit more humane to the person, okay? Yes, Todd has weird fetishes and weird ideas and weird desires. But he will never commit a crime. He's really harmless person. So, I don't agree with that bullshit. Eagles NFC. I don't agree with some of your commentary, but I must give you props. You take all your comments and respond to them. And you don't delete anyone who opposes you or questions your comment. Keep it up, the rules. Thank you. I did block some people. I generally don't like blocking people. And speaking of blocking people, last comment. Emil is a Russian spy. You know what, Tommy Ripton, you are idiot. And if you're gonna keep doing what you're doing, you're the next person in line for me to block.